Now we've written a lot of code, and you must be anxious to see the list of words start to appear on the screen. Well, here's a manual way of making that happen. We've mentioned multiple times that anything you write in the XML of your app, we can actually accomplish in the Java code as well. So I could create a text view object for each element in this list, and then add it as a child view to the current layout. So let's try that approach. First off, I need to start by checking out the layout. So for the numbers activity, we see that the layout is defined in the activity underscore numbers XML file. So I'm gonna open up that file, and then I'm gonna change this relative layout to a linear layout. So every child view that I add to it will just come one right after another in a single column. Additionally, I'm gonna add the orientation attribute to be vertical. Now I'm gonna be adding child views dynamically in Java code. And because of this, I should give this linear layout a view ID so that I can reference it in the Java code later. And I'm gonna call that ID root view. Now let's go back to the numbers activity. So I'm gonna be adding the lines of code to display the list of words at the end of the onCreate method. And I'm gonna do this after I've created my array list. I can go ahead and delete these log messages because I already know my list was created properly. So I'm gonna close the project panel on the side so we can see the code better. So what I need to do in the Java code is that first I need to find the linear layout that I called root view and store it in a variable. And then I can start creating and adding text views to this linear layout. So to do so, I need to start off by using findViewById method to find the view with the ID root view. And this will return a view to me. But I need to cast it specifically into a linear layout data type. And I do so so that I can add child views to it. Now I'll store this view in the root view variable so that I can use it later. And remember to end it with a semicolon. Nice. So remember this line helps me find the linear layout called root view, and I'm gonna store it in this variable called root view. And remember next, I need to create and add text views to this linear layout we just created. So start off by creating the text view object. So I'm gonna use this constructor, which requires a context as its only input. Remember to help us understand which constructor to use, we can always check the documentation. So here's the documentation for the TextView class. And I'm going to scroll down to the section about public constructors. So here we see there are a couple of possible constructors we could have used. And each of them has a different number of inputs. But I'm going to go ahead and use this first one, which takes in one input, context. Remember that every time you create a view in Java code, you need to pass in a context so that the view knows the theme and other information about the app in which it will be displayed. So it gives it context as to what's going on around it. Now in this case, we have this passed in as the input for this constructor. And since this class is the number activity class, this will also be the context. All right, so now this line of code has helped me create a text view object that is stored in a variable called wordView, whose data type is a text view. So to change the text that is displayed on screen, I call the setText method on the wordView object. And I pass in one input, which is the desired text. In this case, I want the text view to display the string stored in the words list at the 0th index. And so this should help us map to the word one. Now that we have a wordView object with the correct text inside, I'm going to add the view as a child to the parent view called root view. So this is our child view, word view, and this is our parent view, root view. So I'm adding the child view, word view, using the .addView method to the parent view, root view. All right, so let's run this code in our app and see what happens. All right, so now when we go into the numbers activity, nice. So we see the word one, which was from the 0th element of our word array list. So what we've done here is dynamically created a text view in Java code based on the first element in the array list. And at this point, you're probably starting to think of all the possibilities. So what if we repeat the same code for all the other elements in the list? Then we could show a list of words on the screen. So let's give that a try with a couple more views. So I'm going to copy these three lines of code that helped us create a text view for the word one, paste it below, and then modify it to help us create a text view for the word to. So it looks like I'm getting an error here, and it says the variable word view is already defined in the scope. And that means that you can only define a local variable once with the same name within the same scope. And the scope that it's referring to here is the method. So to help with that, I'll pick a different name and call it WordView2. Then I'm going to update the code below to reflect that. Great, so now we have a block of code that creates another text view called WordView2, and we add that text view to the parent view root view. Oh, but wait a second, I want this second text view to display the next word at the first index. So instead of words.get0, I'll change it to words.get1 to get the string located at the index 1 in the list. So now let's copy and paste that section and make some modifications to display the third word in the list. All right, so let's give it a test and see what happens. Well, we run the app on our device and hit numbers. Nice. So in the numbers activity, we print out a list of 1, 2, and 3, which are the first three elements of our array list. All right, so we could continue this approach of copy and pasting and making modifications to the text view and the indexes, but it's going to get really tedious. And we also need to style these text views to make them look better. Right now, it's just plain text. Well, we might have well just done all this in XML and just copy and pasted the XML element over and over and over again. Well, hang on for a moment. In writing this Java code, we do start to see a pattern. So notice that each block of code for each text view is really similar. And the main difference is that the index position is changing from one block to another. So see that we're incrementing the index from 0, 1, 2, and so on and so on. So I've rewritten the code based on the pattern we saw. So what if we replace the integer variable that tracks our current index position in the list, and then just update it by 1 each time? So notice that these blocks of code are looking more and more similar. So they all call words.get, and they pass in index as the input. And we just have extra code now that increases the index value by 1. So now I'm going to introduce you to an awesome new programming concept called loops. And once you learn about loops, I'm going to ask you to fix this code so that you can display all the words on the screen without copy and pasting this block of code over and over again 10 times.